The tumors that occur in children actually are quite different from those that occur in adults, and generally the break point is around the early 20s, when the adult kind of cancers take over and the childhood cancers become much rarer. Surprisingly, we don't think of cancer in children as very common, but it turns out that 1 in 350 children in the United States develops cancer before the age of 20, and there's about 12,500 new cases of childhood cancer in the United States each year. The diseases are different in children and adults, and of course children have different needs than adults. So although we still use the same methods, surgery, radiation, chemotherapy, the kinds of regimens that we use are different. Over the past three or four decades, the prognosis for children with cancer has improved dramatically, and we now cure almost 80% of children with cancer. We cure 90% of the children with the most common childhood cancer, which is acute lymphoblastic leukemia. Progress in the treatment of childhood cancer is one of the great success stories of modern medicine. In the last three or four decades, we have made enormous progress in treating almost all of the different childhood cancers. How we've made this progress is through clinical trials. We have run trials comparing therapies, comparing new strategies to old strategies, and with each trial we have made a little bit of progress. But added together over 4 to 5 decades, this has translated into enormous improvement in outcome. So the majority of children in the United States are entered on clinical trials through pediatric cancer centers and children's hospitals, and that's the way we have made progress. We have to understand that when we treat a child with cancer, we're really treating an entire family. And there are other needs that are unique to children. Schooling, something that we don't really think about, but children, that's what children do, and they have to go to school. Also, the family, transportation, who's going to take care of the other children? These are some of the needs that are best served in centers that are specifically geared to take care of children with cancer, notably the major children's hospitals in the United States and the major cancer centers. This is probably where the majority of children should get the best care, both in terms of the specific anti-cancer therapy and all of the supportive care needs that they have. We understand that some families live too far from a major center or a children's hospital to get all of their care there, but they can still take advantage of clinical trials and the expertise available at those centers by having the care choreographed by that center. They could have their care choreographed at the center and then have the majority of the care actually take place closer to home under the auspices of a medical oncologist or somebody suitably trained to do so. The challenges for the future is to design therapies that minimize those late effects so that we improve the quality and quantity of life for the survivors. And then for those patients that we don't yet have curative therapy for, we need new therapies. The challenge for us is to incorporate new targeted therapies into our current treatments to improve the outcome. In addition, we have the problems of the cost of cure. Children who survive their cancer are left with a number of side effects related to the therapy that they have received. Some of the important advances lately have been the development of targeted therapies, where we really understand the molecular basis of the cancer and use a drug that is specific to that pathway that drives the cancer. And this has proven to be enormously successful in some adult cancers, but also in childhood cancers as well. There's been very exciting results in childhood acute lymphoblastic leukemia, where we take the patient's T cells and educate them to target their own leukemia, and then give those T cells back. And this has been very exciting in children who have refractory leukemia who are actually going into remission with this treatment. We have some very exciting technologies on the horizon, including immunotherapy, use of CAR T cells. These are all therapies which hold great promise for treatments of cancer. We already have preliminary information about how successful they can be, and so our challenge is to incorporate that into therapies for children to improve their outcome. Some of the most exciting findings now are attempts to manipulate the immune system of the patient in an effort to allow the immune system to attack the patient's tumor. There's a wonderful resource that is great for parents and families at Cancer.Net. Here they have available information for all the different types of childhood cancer. Some of the questions that you should be asking your physician to make sure that you're getting all of the information you need to decide the best care and make some treatment decisions. There's also additional information on other resources that are available to you at Cancer.Net. This is a site that I recommend for my patients to use, and I recommend it for all families of children with cancer.